Welcome in then to the latest edition of Extra Time. Craig and Ali are here in the studio. Frank is in Norbany, and as we learnt, Jan is in Munich.
Yeah, he is.
Ahead of Bayern Munich's clash against PSG.
Yeah.
What have you done today, Jan? I've got someone asking here, did you watch the Bruges-Benfica game?
Yes, I did.
He's got a better background today, hasn't he?
I watched both games. So I wanted to say in the show, but you just wanted to talk about Cancelo. But don't underestimate Benfica. They got a great coach, Roger Schmidt, who came from, he's a German. He was at PSV Eindhoven, did a great job there. And don't underestimate Benfica.
There's so many great bars in Munich, right?
Right.
Jan must get annoyed when we say, Jan, come on the show, it's late in Germany.
No, Jan loves it, though. He
I
loves
love
it.
To be with you. I love he to be with you.
He could be down one of these, what do you call a pub in Germany? I have no idea. Where's Derek Ray when you need it?
No, I never go to pubs, Craig. I'm not your typical English. I don't go to pubs. I don't like beer.
You played for Sheffield United in Barnsley.
Beerstuber.
You've been in a pub.
You don't see Beerstuber?
Beerstuber, yeah, you know. That's true. True. Well done, Frank.
Yeah.
I don't know any Norwegians that didn't like a beer. He's lying.
You must be German quite a few times. You don't know the word for a pub. Quite surprises me, to be honest.
What was that again?
I didn't live there. Like you lived in Spain.
No, but I know what a pub is in Spanish. I know those bits, but when you're in Germany...
I didn't walk in a bar in Stuttgart and go, hey, what's the name of this? What's German for pub? I just went, give me a beer. Large.
Two.
What's the cheapest? I love that.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Frank, does Chelsea...
Berlin? I won't go there.
Frank, what happened?
Does Chelsea's win virtually secure Potter's job until next campaign, regardless of the Premier League outcome?
No, I don't think so. I think it will last for maybe one or two games, but if they lose the next two games, maybe it would be time for the board to think about something else for the next season. I don't know. There is the Champions League campaign. I don't think the club will want to change the coach, you know, because of that Champions League campaign. But if they feel that something is happening that they can't resolve, they're gonna get rid of Potter and try maybe like it happened in 2013 and the last time they won the Champions League, maybe a reaction from the players to maybe win that Champions League. So it's possible. It's even more, in fact, thinking about that Potter is more in the edge if they feel that he can win the Champions League.
I don't think they're changing him. I think he's going to be in charge
right
at the end of the season. I do.
Let's see what happens. Jan. How disappointed are you that a team tied for first place in the Bundesliga just lost to a Premier League relegation candidate over two legs? Here's a kicker. Here's the kicker as well. Will Derek Ray ever recover from this? No. Well, this is someone who knows the show very well.
Well, first of all, I would say that Derek Ray would say, Bierstube! He will say that in a stretch for a bub. He will do that brilliantly. Yes, I think that we see that all the time. We see Manchester City, we see RB Leipzig when they're playing. It's all about this German-English kind of thing. Do I think that Dortmund, RB Leipzig and the teams are ready to go all the way? No, I don't. I can see two or three teams in England doing that. So I think that Dortmund will feel down over these two games. But again, we have to give a compliment to Chelsea. They deserved it over two games.
We have to discuss Derek's viewing of the game.
Oh, no.
Living in the Boston, Massachusetts area, having availability, I believe he's got a TV in his house.
Right.
I don't even know if he was watching the game. But he was listening to the game, as we know, via his social media account on German radio.
Yes, he loves German, doesn't he? Loves everything German.
And he was moaning about the German radio, moaning about the commentary position at Stamford Bridge for the German radio, which was just behind the technical area. And the German radio station wasn't able to describe the game properly because of the position, and this was really annoying Derek.
Yep.
This isn't quite in the Weghorst getting annoyed about something you shouldn't, but it's quite close. Because at that point, you're just saying, switch the TV on, there's commentary. You might not like it, but there's commentary.
Yeah, well, it's not in German, though, is it?
It's not in German.
Yep, that's the thing.
But nobody loves German football, like Eric Gray.
No, exactly.
It's not just that. I've come across him before when he said, I was listening to Dutch radio.
Oh. Wow.
God.
There you go.
Well, Eric.
Nobody loves Dutch football like Derek Ray loves Dutch football.
Away from the Champions League, Ali, why are there so many red cards in La Liga? There have been 98 in comparison to 20 in the Premier League and 30 in the Bundesliga. Does this indicate the Spanish referees are the best in the world or the second worst in the world after the English ones, obviously? Officiating is not good in Spain.
It's inconsistent. And they try, in, at the beginning of the season, to come up with sort of different narratives or things that they're gonna try to enforce more closely. And what ends up happening is that they end up overcommitting. They end up sort of, instead of finding a happy medium and just make the right call that is in front of you, no, then they go the opposite way, overcorrecting. And so it takes some time to then come back to normal and actually begin to make calls that are sensible. Look, it's inconsistent. Sometimes the use of VAR in Spain can be inconsistent and has been across Europe. But this weekend, the Barcelona match, late, where Fran Kessié touches Fran Pérez as he's going into the box, should have been a penalty. The referee called it a corner kick, so you assume, okay, well, there was a touch by Fran Kessié. There was no touch on the ball ever by Fran Kessié. So, obviously, by logical decision, VAR would have suggested to the referee, hey, come and take a look at it, because there was no touch by the defender player, in this case, Fran Kessié. No, there was never a call from VAR. When those things happen, that's when you kind of go, what's going on here? Why do we have the system? Why don't we use it properly? And why are these referees, who you can excuse are missing a call in live action, not being helped and actually being assisted by the VAR, who actually gets a chance to watch replays? That's the part that I think can be really frustrating.
They're all bad.
You hate Barcelona.
Huh?
Why do you hate Barcelona so much?
I was just pointing out sequence of events that highlights some of the refereeing concerns that you just asked about.
Anti-La Liga ways. It's the
all the leagues, apart from Italy. Don said Italy.
Don said Italy is the best league at everything.
Don says Serie A. Referee's perfect.
Yeah, that's everybody fine. Else. And Derek said Germany. The third tier of
Germany. Germany do it differently.
Yes.
They just do it differently. Yeah. To anybody else.
Yep, exactly.
The world.
It's perfect.
Wow.
Yeah, everyone's bad. Everyone's rubbish. Yeah,
Premier League.
All the officials.
Premier League's terrible as well.
Yes, yeah, exactly. How are you, Frank? You well? What's going on in your life?
Everything's all right. I'm going back to Paris tomorrow. And I've got an appointment with the Ministry of the Army for my my charity. And I have a big meeting tomorrow. And then I'm going to watch Paris Saint-Germain. And then I'm going to be with you. For the people involved, you know, in the show. So a big day tomorrow. Otherwise, no, nothing much. Everything nice.
That is a discussion you don't expect on this show. When one of the pundits say, tomorrow I'm gonna have appointment of Minister of Defense in my country. Okay,
yeah.
Good day.
What are you doing tomorrow, Jan, during the day? Because you're getting into the evening, faffing around Munich.
I'm going to comfort Cancelo, I guess.
Yes.
Have a look at it. He's so frustrated. No, I'm going to do the both games and look forward to that.
Yeah, but that's in the evening. What are you going to do during the day, Jan?
During the day, I'm going to train.
Pop.
And then I got another job as well.
Train.
I got a company in Norway. I have to work. I'm going to practice my running.
Do you have it with a fish in the background as motivation?
A picture in the back.
I will ask Cancelo if he can be the fish.
He's got nothing else to do.
Please listen, if you see Cancelo tomorrow, Jan, please tell him we had a really off-the-cuff conversation about.
Yeah, saying that, getting deep about it.
I will say that the great Dan didn't just wanted to talk about Conte, but I wanted to talk about you, Cancelo, because for me, you are more important.
No, you brought it, Jan. I appreciate it. There we go. You can do the rundown. Craig, does Potter now have his starting 11 for the rest of the campaign?
No.
Why not?
It would never watch like that, does it?
No. No, it doesn't.
Right.
Right. Okay. That's the end of that.
Good job, guys.
It's a bit like saying, is this now the...
Well, we know, eventually Jan will be sat in this chair.
Yes.
Jan will be here in the host chair.
What could possibly go wrong?
And you can go to Munich.
Oh, I could
sit in your hotel room.
I know. Do 5 minutes, bish, bash, bosh.
And chunter on a bit Cancelo.
Yes. And there we go. I maybe would go out in the Munich lifetime.
No, there's no maybe about it.
Arsenal have a run of fixtures, finally, in April, May, where they play. Get ready for this, Frank. City away, Chelsea at home, Newcastle away, Brighton at home. Is it fair to say that the title race will be decided over those four games?
Yeah, of course. But, you know, Arsenal showed to the world that even having a bad performance doesn't destroy them, and they can recover. And they still have their 5 points ahead. So, yeah, it's going to be hard. Yeah, it's going to be challenging, but it's what the Premier League has been. But you, when you are top of the league, you know, I think it's 12 games before the end, it's because you know how to end the whole games after games. And yeah, it's going to be hard, but it's possible for the Gunners because they've showed many, many qualities. And the first one is strength and confidence.
You see that Sean Malone got two questions into it?
Yeah. Wow, did he?
It's a good day.
By the way, I don't choose. Everyone thinks I choose the. I do not choose the questions.
Who chooses the questions?
Our boss chooses the questions, not me. But people say, "Oh, you never choose my question, or you only prefer Nadim's interior decorator."
Well, yeah, that appears a lot.
Yes, it doesn't matter though.
Big fan of the show.
There you go.
We should be appreciative.
By the way, yes. Nadim's interior decorator asked the question if one of us have seen the game. Bruges against Benfica, where in fact, Mr. Needham's interior decorator, it was Benfica against Bruges, the other way around.
I think
maybe
we need
he
to
didn't watch the game too.
I really think we need to branch out in terms of letting not the same people.
But the problem is if the other questions are dross, what are you supposed to do?
Give people a chance.
Yeah, but they need to up their game when it comes to their questions.
But they don't know that.
Well, of course they do. You think, if I don't get selected, maybe I'll ask something more interesting.
Let's be more positive. Sean Malone got two questions in today.
This is a very uninteresting show.
Good job, Sean.
That's why I changed it. Thank you.
Very sorry, guys, but it's very late for Jan and myself, so if you have nothing else to say, we're going to say goodbye to everybody.
Frank!
Just because you're down in Normandy, you got to Normandy.
What kind of discussion
is that? Ministry of Defence, your charity, faffing about
there. Spends a lot of time in Normandy these days, doesn't he?
Oh, well, yeah, he's got. Have you seen it?
Well, catching animals.
Oh, he can bore you with all the details. The beams are 350 years old, look at the swimming pool. I won the World Cup, blah, blah, blah.
I bet when he goes there, the house is like, even the house, if the house could talk, he went, he's going to chunter on about winning
the World Cup. I know. Do you want a tour? No, I really don't. I just want a beer, but right, here we go. This is the original stonework. Great. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Goodbye. See you later. Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN+.